Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Live from Silver Surfer Studios, I'm Stanley Kirby, along with our panel of regulars, Professor Charles Xavier, Victor Von Doom, and of course, as always, Sir Charles Barkley. Tonight, we'll be looking over what went right and what went wrong with the Avengers during their confrontation with the Mad Titan, Thanos. This is the Avengers Postgame. Well, it was the first major loss for the men and women of the Avengers, and it really cost them half the world's population. Gone with the snap of a finger.
Well, you're right about that, Stan. It was just a truly terrible thing to happen. Just terrible. I was having lunch with Shaggy at Taco Bell, and he just disappeared before I even opened his $5 box. The box that rocks. Terrible.
I believe the key to Thanos' victory had to be due to the Star-Lord's inability to keep his emotions in check. If he could have waited until after the Infinity Gauntlet had been removed before interrogating the Mad Titan, I think we would have seen a much different outcome.
Perhaps you forgot the opportunity the Scarlet Witch had in which to destroy the Mind Stone. Face it! The Avengers were weak from the outset, thanks to the division in the team over the fallout of the Sokovia Accords.
You might be onto something with that, Victor.
Call me Dr. Doom, pathetic insect.
My apologies, Doctor, but to your point, if Tony Stark could have put aside his issues and contacted Captain America when he first learned of Thanos, a united team may have beaten the Mad Titan.
I agree, Stanley. Playing defense on multiple fronts only weakens your team. On top of that, they didn't go to the bench and missed out on having some really strong players on the floor. Nick Fury is one of the team's best defensive players, and he set out the whole game. Terrible.
But you can't deny the ingenuity of Steve Rogers. Captain America really brought his A-game when he brought the fight to Wakanda, where a literal army was waiting to fight alongside the Avengers.
But it wasn't enough, was it? All that weakling did was postpone his inevitable defeat!
Why was Dr. Bruce Banner unable to bring forth the Hulk?
I can't say for sure, but I know for myself, sometimes getting beat on the court can be a real blow to the self-confidence. Maybe the Hulk couldn't get out of his own head and focus on the next battle, but Banner sure did look smooth in that Hulkbust armor. Am I right? Terrible.
The word is terrible!
That's what I said, terrible.
Well, a rematch is looming, and the Avengers, though they are down a few key players, have managed to get a couple of new players on the hardwood for this go-around.
Yes! The addition of Scott Lang will be most interesting to watch, especially given his experience in the quantum realm.
Bah! Thanos will reign supreme once again! Long live the Mad Titan!
Don't be too sure. I think I think the new lady is going to be the key to turning this around.
Well, we're just going to have to wait and see what happens in this next matchup. We're just about out of time, so for Professor Xavier, Victor Von Doom,
Doctor, you imbecile!
And Charles Barkley, I'm Stanley Kirby saying goodnight, true believers, and Avengers, assemble!